taking it out of the box, I can show you guys what it looks like. In my opinion, it's a lot nicer looking than the other brushes I tried. It looks a little bit different. It's a little bit heavier. It has some settings on the handle. It says ionic and then the on off and temperature set. So I'm going to plug this in and have it heat up, and then we'll take a look at the directions so I don't mess anything up. So in this video, I will be trying the Chase method as suggested by some commenters, and then I will be trying to brush from underneath my hair as suggested by the comments as well. So let us take a look at the directions. Okay, so it talks about PTC heating. PTC stands for positive temperature coefficient. So it's ceramic stones with self-limiting temperature characteristics, fast heating response times, and it gives heat, even heat distribution and quick temperature recovery time. It is in Celsius to begin with, but to switch the temperature display from Celsius to Fahrenheit, you hold down both of the buttons on the handle at the same time, and then the C will blink and then switch to Fahrenheit. So I am going to put it at the highest temperature it can go, which is 446 degrees Fahrenheit. So I will let this heat up and then I'll read about how long it takes to heat up. So at the temperature I have it, it is suitable for thick and very curly hair or difficult to style hair. So I would say that is mine. So when the brush is done heating up, this temperature will stop blinking. But right now it is still blinking. So it suggests that you use small pieces of hair and to hold your hair tight when you're passing the brush through your hair. I really hope this works because, guys, they've been getting better as my reviews go, so I'm hoping that this one will be better. So while that is heating up, I will section off a part of my hair like usual, and then I will be combing this part out. Okay, and then to prep my hair for straightening, I have the Tresemme Thermal Creations Heat Tamer Leave-In Spray. So I will be lightly spritzing this on my hair. Okay, the temperature has stopped blinking, so that means that it is fully heated up. So let us try to pass this through a smaller chunk of hair. It says start with the bottom and then go to the top. So this is a fairly small piece of hair. So let us try to brush through this. Okay, and then I'm going to try the Chase method. Okay, it's doing a better job than the other ones. It leaves my hair really shiny and it doesn't smell or feel burnt or hot. So that is a plus, guys. Okay, and since this is I'm gonna try it on a little bit bigger piece of hair, and I'm going to chase with a bigger brush and see if that works. Okay, and then let me try underneath. Okay, I'm gonna say that I'm getting better results with this brush than any other brush, but I wanna try one more thing, so I'll be right back. I'm gonna grab my blow dryer and I'm gonna actually blow out a part of my hair and then chase it with the brush, because I feel like if you could blow out your hair before going through with this brush, then it would make it a lot easier, because you would typically blow out your hair before you would straighten it. So I wonder if I did that first and then tried chasing it with the brush, if I would get better results. Okay, so I got my blow dryer. I'm going to section off another piece and then I'm going to comb it out and then blow dry this side of my hair. Okay, so let's spritz it with some heat protectant. Okay, so I blow dried this section of my hair. I'm going to put a little bit more heat protectant on. I'm just gonna spray some in my hand and kind of run it through. All right, so let's see if I pass this through blown out hair, if it has better results. Okay, so it does take a couple passes, but like overall, I do believe that this brush has done a better job than all of them. It feels better, it makes my hair feel better, it doesn't feel burnt, and like overall, this would work for wavy hair and it would straighten your hair. My hair is hard to straighten in general, but this, if anything, can fix your already flat ironed hair and could do a decent job at straightening curly hair. It could be just my hair texture, because my hair texture is fine, but I just have a lot of it. So, I mean, overall, I would say it did a decent job. I don't hate it as much as I hated the other ones, actually, to be honest. So, out of all of the ones that I've reviewed, I'm probably going to keep this one because I do like it. I like what it looks like, feels like. It's easier to use. The bristles are not staggered. Let me go get another one. Hold on. So if you look at the other ones that I have reviewed, there are a lot more bristles and it does get caught in your hair a little bit more. This one has, if you can see, the panels are just straight across all the way down. So it does glide through your hair a lot easier. This tends to get caught if your hair isn't all the way combed out. Overall, I would recommend this brush. I actually like this brush a lot better than I did the other ones. I assume if I did my entire head with this, it would actually look decent compared to the other ones, because it did get the curls out. If you look at this side, it got the curls out. It's just not like as straight as a flat iron would do it. But if you have wavy hair and you are just trying to get it straight, this is a great brush for you.